Dear students, in our last lecture, we had seen about the quantum chemistry and we had started with particle in one-dimensional box. In that, we had seen about the derivation of the particle moving in one-dimensional box, that is along the x-axis. Now, in this lecture, we will continue the discussions on the particle in one-dimensional box. Here, we will see the normalization of the equation that we have derived, and then we will plot it into the graph. That how the path traverses and what will be the probability densities of particle moving in one-dimensional box.
In that one-dimensional box, and in that one-dimensional box, we have derived the energy for one-dimensional box as E is equal to m square h square upon 8 ma square. And also we have derived wave function for one-dimensional box as psi is equal to a sine n pi x by a, where small a, this is a limit of the box, while capital A is a normalization constant or any arbitrary constant. The value of it, we have to just determine it. Energy of the system will be given by E is equal to n square h square upon 8 ma square, and from that we can know that as n can take values of 1, 2, 3, the energy will be quantized. It cannot have all the energies possible, but it can have only discrete energies. So that gave a difference from the classical mechanics, which predicted that a particle can have every energy possible. But this shows that it can have only discrete energies, energy levels only, not all of them are possible for this one-dimensional particle in a one-dimensional box. Also, from this energy, we can say that as n cannot have zero values, n has the smallest value as 1, so we can have the lowest energy possible will be lowest energy value of particle is obtained at n is equal to 1, that is E is equal to h square upon 8 pi square, h square upon 8 ma square. H square upon 8 ma square. This is the lowest amount of energy that will be present even at absolute zero temperature. So this shows that the particle in a box will always be in a state of motion. It will not be stationary even at 0 degree Celsius, even at 0 degree Kelvin. This energy level is called as zero point energy. We have studied this zero point energy concept in vibrational spectroscopy in TYBSC. So this will be having a motion of vibrations will be available with the particle, but it will always be in a motion, movement will be there. The other energies will be little higher, that is E2 and E3 and so on. So those energies will always be present. Now when we look at the wave function that we have arrived at, wave function that we have got it as a solution, psi is equal to a sine n pi x by a. We have to still determine the value of a, which can be determined by normalization of the wave function. So we can do the normalization of this wave function. We have psi is equal to a sine n pi x by a. And the condition for normalization is integration of I square d tau from 0 to a, as the wave function is between this one dimensional box only. So from 0 to a will be equal to 1. That is integration of this a square sine square n pi x by a dx from 0 to a should be equal to 1. So from this we can find out the value of a. Okay, as a is constant, can be taken outside, and we have sine square theta is equal to 1 minus cos 2 theta upon 2. This we had done it previously when we had started Schrodinger's wave equation. वहाँ पे मैंने कुछ trigonometric relations आपको दिए थे, उसमें से एक था sine square theta equals 1 minus cos 2 theta by 2. Substituting this for this sine square theta, where we have theta equals n pi x by a. So instead of theta, we will substitute n pi x by a in this particular equation, and we are taking out this a square. We will get integration of a square from 0 to a. Sine square theta will now become 1 minus cos 2 theta, so it is cos 2 n pi x pi a whole divided by 2 into dx. Now this can be, this 2 can be taken outside, so it will be a square by 2 into integration from 0 to a 1 minus cos 2n pi x by a dx. Now this integration we can do it very easily. Sin square theta ka integration karna thoda difficult hota hai, ye easy hoga hamare liye. So this we can do it as a square by 2 will remain as such. पहले 1 का होगा इंटीग्रेशन एंड देन कॉस फंक्शन का इंटीग्रेशन. सो 1 का इंटीग्रेशन, 1 इज अ कांस्टेंट, सो इंटीग्रेशन ऑफ दिस विल बी x फ्रॉम 0 टू a माइनस कॉस का जो इंटीग्रेशन होगा दैट विल बी sin, इंटीग्रेशन ऑफ cos इज sin थीटा डिवाइडेड बाय, दैट इज वी हैव इंटीग्रेशन ऑफ cos m थीटा इक्वल्स sin m थीटा डिवाइड बाय m. Sin m theta divided by m. So here m is 2n pi by a. Our variable is x. So whatever other things are there, that is our constant. So we'll have it here as sin 2n pi x by a divided by 2n pi by a from 0 to a. This is our equals to 1, which will remain as equal to 1. So now, when we expand this from low upper limit minus lower limit, we will get a square by 2. Here, upper limit is a, so a minus lower limit 0 minus, here upper limit is a, so sine 2n pi a by a minus lower limit, that is sine x is substituted by 0, so it will be completely 0, so sine 0 divided by 2n pi by a equals to 1. So this will be a square by 2. Here it will be a minus sine 0 is 0. And here this a and a gets cancelled. So we will have here as A minus, this will be 0, 2n pi is 0, we have sine n pi is equal to 0. So anything multiple of this will also be equal to 0. Similarly, we have sine 0 is equal to 0. Therefore, both these terms will be equal to 0. So 0 minus 0 by 2n pi by a equals to 1. This becomes a square by 2 a minus 0 equal to 1, or we have this a can be brought on the other side and in the denominator, and 2 will be on the numerator, so we will have a square equals 2 by a, or a equals to under root 2 by a. So we got this particular value of a, and this can be substituted in our original equation, that is psi. So we will have the normalized wave function is psi equals under root 2 by a sine n pi x by a. So we will have this particular normalized wave function. So in this way, we can do the normalization of this wave function. And when we substitute the values of n in this particular equation, what we get is by substituting values of n equals to 1, 2, 3, we will get the wave functions directly. So we will get psi 1 equals under root 2 by a sine of, now n is 1, so it will be sine pi x by a. Psi 2 will be equal to under root 2 by a sine 2 pi x by a. Similarly, psi 3 will be equal to under root 2 by a sine of 3 pi x by a. When we plot this particular equations in a graph, in a graphical representation, we will get this becomes easier for us to draw. Here what we can have is, on this side we have a x, that is psi of 1, psi 1 of x, this is say psi 2 of x, and this has psi 3 of x. For n is equal to 1, 2 and 3. Same figure we will require it once more also. So we are just taking that only. यहाँ पर हमारा होगा we will be plotting. Psi 1 square, psi 2 square and psi 3. Square, so that we will get the probability densities of the same functions. Now when we plot this psi 1 of x, we will get the value will be somewhat like this. Value will be somewhat like this, and its square when we will give it, the function will be this. We are going from x is equal to 0 to x is equal to a. This is our one dimensional box. So when we are going from x is equal to a to x equal 0 to a, we will get this wave function. For psi 2 of x, we will have a node at 0 at the middle, because when we observe the function psi 1 of x, is it this is a constant under root 2 by a. The function is sine of pi by pi x by a. Now this will be equal to pi, because sine function will be equal to 0 only at 0 and pi or multiples of pi. So yahan par x jab hamara a ho jayega, x is equal to a hoga, tab ye hamara function hoga sine pi. So sine pi will be equal to 0. So wo hamara function jo hamara pehle x is equal to 0 pe 0 tha aur baad mein x is equal to a par hamara 0 hua, in between it is not having any. हमारा फंक्शन मैक्सिमम कब होगा, व्हेन इट विल बी साइन विल बी इक्वल टू 90 डिग्री, थीटा इज 90 डिग्री आएगा, तो साइन फंक्शन हमारा मैक्सिमम होता है. सो थीटा इक्वल्स टू 90 डिग्री मींस एक्स हियर पाई एक्स बाय ए शुड बी पाई बाय 2, दैट इज एक्स बाय ए शुड बी इक्वल टू 1 बाय 2. तो एक्स जब हमारा ए बाय 2 होगा, एक्स जब हमारा ए बाय 2 होगा, दैट इज मैक्सिमम एट x is equal to a by 2. ये अगर हम यहाँ पे substitute करते हैं तो we will get psi 1 equals under root 2 by a sine of pi x by x is a by 2 divided by a. A a gets cancelled, ये pi यहाँ 2 नीचे आएगा. We will have under root by 2 sine of pi by 2. So sine of pi by 2 is 1. So our maximum will be psi 1 is equal to under root 2 by a. That is at the middle. Middle we will have maximum. A by 2 है, यहाँ पे हमारा 0 है और यहाँ पर हमारा a है. So ये 0 से a तक के बीच में यहाँ पे a by 2 आता है. So there we will have the function as maximum probability. जब psi 2 पे हम देखते हैं तो psi 2 पे it is 2 by x by a. So ये 2 by x by a में जब हम x is equal to 0 लगाते हैं तो it will be completely 0. Sin 0 is 0. Then if we put x is equal to a by 2, इस function में हम x is equal to a by 2 करते हैं, तो ये function होगा हमारा sin 2 pi a by 2 divided by a. So this will be this 2 and this 2 gets cancelled, ये a और ये a cancel हो जाएगा, it will be sin pi. Sin pi is 0, means a by 2 पे at a by 2 it will be equal to 0. पहला वाला फंक्शन a by 2 में मैक्सिमम होता था, psi 2 हमारा a by 2 में 0 हो जाएगा. सो एट मिडिल वी विल हैव अ 0 पॉइंट ओवर हियर. इसका मैक्सिमम होगा पाई बाय 4 एंड 3 पाई बाय 4. सो वी विल हैव दिस फंक्शन एज समवॉट लाइक दिस. फिर यहां से वो नीचे जाएगा एंड देन इट विल बी कमिंग ओवर हियर. सिमिलरली हमारा जब psi 3 हम देखते हैं तो psi 3 विल बी 0 एट टू डिफरेंट पोजीशंस. psi 3 will be 0 at this two position. Ye jo positions hai, which are 0, these are called as nodes. This is node over here. जहां पे हमारा फंक्शन जीरो हो जाता है दैट पॉइंट वी आर कॉलिंग इट एट नोड एंड जो मैक्सिमम पॉइंट होता है जो मीन पॉइंट ऑफ मैक्सिमम जहां पे साई वैल्यू हमारा मैक्सिमम होता है दैट वी कॉल इट एज एंटी नोड सो दिस इज आवर एंटी नोड पोजीशंस एंड दिस टू आर नोड पोजीशंस इन साई 3 साई 1 में हमारा एक नोड है सॉरी साई 1 में हमारा एक भी नोड नहीं है वी डू नॉट टेक दिस स्टार्ट एंड एंड पॉइंट्स वी विल टेक इन बिटवीन हमारा कितना है So in between में हमारा एक भी नोड नहीं है साई 1 में साई 2 में 1 नोड भी है साई 3 में हमारे दो नोड्स हैं सो नंबर ऑफ नोड्स फॉर दिस विल बी 2 1 0 सो व्हाट वी कैन से इज दैट नंबर ऑफ नोड्स इज इक्वल टू एन माइनस 1 यहाँ पे जो भी हमारी एन की वैल्यू है उसका माइनस 1 करोगे तो आपको नंबर ऑफ नोड्स मिलेंगे ये आपके एमसीक्यूज में आ सकता है And also in your competitive exams, this will be asked. So, यहाँ पे nodes, number of nodes निकालने हैं, so that will be equal to your principal quantum number minus 1. Will be giving you number of nodes. ये आपका simple figure है. इसका थोड़ा सा complexity होता है, वो हम next year, next semester में देखेंगे. जहाँ पे अगर हमारा azimuthal quantum number भी अगर हम consider करते हैं, So that will be giving us the number of nodes equals to n minus l minus 1. L is azimuthal quantum number, n is principal quantum number. So that will be giving us this n minus l minus 1. Again, abhi ke liye, simplicity ke liye, it is n minus 1 is the number of nodes in this particular cases because we do not have any l. Sirf hamara n bhi hai yahan pe, so n mein hamara yahan pe ye milega. इसी का अगर आप प्लॉट करोगे स्क्वायर में तो ये यहाँ पे मिडिल तक तो कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है दिस विल बी गिविंग अस लाइक दिस फिगर ये वाला जो नेगेटिव पोर्शन है अगर स्क्वायर करोगे तो ये नेगेटिव का पॉजिटिव हो जाता है सो इट विल बी गिविंग दिस सिमिलरली साई 3 स्क्वायर विल बी समवॉट लाइक दिस प्रोबेबिलिटी नेवर गोज डाउन एज नेगेटिव प्रोबेबिलिटी विल ऑलवेज बी पॉजिटिव सो दिस विल बी अवर प्रोबेबिलिटी डेंसिटी प्लॉट That is probability of finding a particle within the space. So, यहाँ पे ये जो node region है, that shows that there will not be any particle at node. Node में हमारा कोई particle नहीं होगा. Anti nodes में हमारा particle होने का maximum chance. Anti node में maximum chance होगा particle का and node में zero chance होगा particle का रहने का. That you have to remember it. Similarly, when we observe these graphs, these plots, for psi 1, it is symmetric. When we plot the graph over here, dotted lines yahan par nahi hai, we can have it, say, if this is our center point line, Then, just on the left-hand side of this center point and right-hand side of the center point, if it is mirror images are there, then the function is called as symmetric. If it is anti-mirror image, then it will be called as anti-mirror image means yahan ka positive, udhar mein negative hota hai. So it is called as a asymmetric function. Yahan pe jab hum psi 1 ko dekhte hain, to both sides are mirror images of each other. So psi 1 is symmetric. So psi 1 is symmetric, psi 3 is also symmetric, but psi 1, 2 is anti-symmetric or asymmetric. Psi 2 is asymmetric while psi 1 and psi 3 are symmetric. So the symmetric wave functions and asymmetric wave functions can be obtained. The wave functions can be of two types. One is symmetric wave function when we have psi of x is equal to psi of minus x. When we have psi of x is equal to psi of minus x, then the wave function is called as symmetric, or the half of it is mirror image of the other. Half of plot is mirror image of other. ये हमारा plot का अगर हम देखते हैं तो, लेकिन अगर wave function से ही just हमको देखना है तो psi of x is equal to psi of minus x जब ये होगा, then the function is called as symmetric wave function. The other is asymmetric wave function. This asymmetric wave function has a characteristic as psi of x equals minus psi of minus x. Psi of x equals minus psi of minus x. Then it will be asymmetric. For this particular wave function, we have psi 1, psi 3, psi 5, and all odd n's. Odd n are all symmetric wave functions, while here we will have psi 2, psi 4, and so on, all even n numbers. Even n numbers होंगे वो हमारे asymmetric wave functions होंगे, और odd n number वाले हमारे symmetric wave functions होंगे for one dimensional box. For one dimensional box, it will be the relationship. ये हमारा आपको exams में MCQs में पूछ सकते हैं, या फिर अगर आप नेट सेट की तैयारी कर रहे हो तो वहां पर भी ये आपको पूछा जा सकता है. दिस आर वेरी सिंपल, रिमेम्बर होने का करने का ट्रिक भी बहुत इजी है. अगर ऑड नंबर है n का तो इट विल बी सिमेट्रिक, इवन नंबर होगा तो एसिमेट्रिक, या फिर उसका अगर प्लॉटिंग दिया गया है तो प्लॉट में मिरर इमेजेस है तो सिमेट्रिक, मिरर इमेज नहीं है तो इट इज एसिमेट्रिक. That way it can be easily remembered.